Hi, let's talk about the abdominal aorta. In this video, we'll discuss the branches of the abdominal aorta and their targets. The abdominal aorta enters the abdominal pelvic cavity posterior to the aorta at approximately the T12 level. It's the aortic hiatus. The abdominal aorta is the continuation of the thoracic aorta, and both can be construed as parts of the descending aorta. The abdominal aorta then continues on and bifurcates at approximately the L4 level into the common iliac arteries. There's also a median sacral artery that leaves there. The common iliac arteries supply the abdominal wall, pelvis, and lower limbs with blood. When we consider the various branches of the abdominal aorta, we should think both about the directionality of the branch as well as the vertebral level that the branch occurs. So there are anteriorly oriented branches of the abdominal aorta to viscera, there are laterally oriented branches, and then there are posterolaterally oriented branches. The anteriorly oriented branches to viscera tend to be the major conduits to the digestive system. So for instance, at the level of T12, we have the celiac trunk. The celiac trunk supplies the derivatives of the embryonic foregut with blood. This would be the abdominal part of the esophagus, through to the proximal duodenum. The transition point here is going to be at about the major duodenal papilla of the second part of the duodenum. The next major branch is the superior mesenteric artery, and that is at the level of L1. The superior mesenteric artery is going to serve the derivatives of the embryonic midgut with blood. That would be the distal duodenum through to the proximal colon or large intestine. The transitional point here is about two-thirds of the way along the transverse colon. And then finally, at approximately the L3 level, we have the inferior mesenteric artery, which is going to supply the hindgut with blood. The hindgut is the distal part of the transverse colon through to the rectum. So celiac trunk at T12, superior mesenteric artery at L1, an inferior mesenteric artery at L3. Laterally then, we have a few very important visceral branches, and we can't see the first ones on here. They're very small, but at approximately the L1 level, we're going to have the middle suprarenal artery. The middle suprarenal artery is going to be blood supply directly from the abdominal aorta out to the suprarenal or adrenal gland. There will also be superior suprarenal arteries and inferior suprarenal arteries supplying those adrenal glands that we'll discuss shortly. The next lateral branches, and probably the most significant lateral branches, are those of the renal arteries. The renal arteries are at that L1 level as well, and they're conducting blood out to the kidneys to be filtered. Those renal arteries give rise to the inferior suprarenal arteries, so complementing the middle suprarenal arteries. The next branch at approximately the L2 level will be the gonadal artery, or arteries. So there's the left gonadal and the right gonadal. Those supply the gonads, so the ovaries or the testes, with blood. And sometimes they're more specifically referred to as either the ovarian or testicular arteries. Finally, we should look at those posterolateral arteries supplying the body wall with blood. Some of them are the highest branching arteries and quite variable. These are at approximately the T12 level. So the inferior phrenic arteries, they supply the inferior or the abdominal surface of the diaphragm with blood. And they're going to give rise to those superior suprarenal arteries. So supplying those suprarenal glands will be superior, middle, and inferior suprarenal arteries, all from different sources. Beyond, so at the L1 through the L4 levels going out, are going to be the lumbar arteries. The lumbar arteries aren't going to be visible in illustrations or photographs unless you take more of a lateral view of the aorta. And even then, in the laboratory, you'd have to elevate the abdominal aorta in order to see these branches. So they're supplying the body wall with blood. So we've discussed the various branches of the abdominal aorta, their associated vertebral level, and their targets. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.